303 Squadron left early access. Let's see what this story-driven historical flight sim has to offer. Hello good people and welcome back. 303 Squadron, here it is. Probably the first game which lets you cycle around a British airfield in the 1940s. You're part of 303 Squadron, like the name of the game already tells you. It was one of the 16 Polish squadrons in the Royal Air Force. It had the highest ratio of shot down enemy aircraft compared to its own losses. You're taking the role of Jan Sumbach, who would become the squadron's leader a few years later. He also was one of the first Allied pilots to engage a Focke-Wulf FW-190 in aerial combat. Many of the people you can interact with on the airfield are based on actual historical persons. This nice take on storytelling is one of the biggest strengths of the game. Another unique element is the mechanic mode. You're able to disassemble parts of the plane and install new or modified parts as time and technology progresses. Each part has its own advantages and disadvantages, like better reliability at the cost of longer reload times. But without further ado, let's jump into a plane and fly. The first thing you might notice here are the graphics. 303 Squadron is just about 20 bucks, so I didn't expect high-end visuals. Looks are fine, but weird glitches like this, probably a river thing down there, will hopefully be fixed in upcoming patches. What you see here are the arcade flight physics. There also is a realistic mode, which we will check out later. And here's my first real point of criticism. Controls are neither arcade nor sim-like. They are somewhere in between, which makes aiming a lot more difficult than it should be. Sharp maneuvers are easily performed by using the keyboard, but controls lack when it comes to precise maneuvering. Less would be more here, and I suggest to the devs to take a look at War Thunder's arcade mouse controls. Tweaking the game towards point and fly would make controlling the plane a lot more fun and precise in arcade mode. So, after getting frustrated with the arcade controls, I plugged in my joystick and throttle unit to try out realistic mode. After binding all keys and axes, things went a lot better. Realistic mode only allows the cockpit camera, but still displays a dynamic aiming reticle. But you can turn it off if you like to aim without support. The gameplay still is very arcadey, but the joystick support is well implemented. Now that we have precise controls over our Hurricane, shooting down the Krauts in their 109s is a breeze. If you score an epic kill, the game switches into some kind of action cam, like you might know from the Sniper Elite games. You can see where your bullets hit the enemy plane and witness its destruction in slow motion. It's another nice feature you're able to turn off if you find it too distracting.
It's clear. Congratulations, 303 Squadron.
So how's mission design? It's a bit clunky. And you're going to bed to start a mission, which is kinda weird. A brief cutscene takes you into the air, and after a little bit of chatter between the pilots, something happens. Usually fighters appear out of nowhere. And here's the next issue. The game wants you to shoot down a certain amount of enemy fighters. It won't continue until you score the required kills, which becomes quite tedious after a while because the AI is dumped like a brick and always does the same maneuvers. It's more challenging to evade your fellow pilots because they tend to bunch up on the last target and consistently crash into your plane while you try to shoot it down. Now, what's my conclusion? 303 Squadron is not a bad game at all, but it isn't good either. Not because it's inherently bad. It rather feels like having been pushed out of early access too early. The game also suffers from a lack of focus. My suggestion would be, ditch the realistic mode, which isn't realistic anyway, and focus on a better arcade flight model, the storytelling aspect, and technical improvements. These efforts combined could improve the game a lot and turn it into an enjoyable experience. Right now it's too rough around the edges, and it sits in an awkward spot between arcade and simulation mechanics, being neither fish nor fowl in the end. The historical aspect on the other side is brilliant and could be a good starting point to expand upon. So, if you want to support the devs, then click the Steam link in the description below and get the game. One thing is for sure, it has lots of potential and maybe a diamond in the rough. Chances are good because the devs are very keen to get feedback and they seem to have responded to almost every single review on Steam so far. With that said, some of you may enjoy the game right now, as you can see by the many positive entries in the Steam review section. So don't let my mixed review irritate you too much. As always, don't rely on a single source and always form your own opinion. And that's it for today. If you enjoyed the video, then feel free to like and subscribe. Hit that thumbs down button if you'd rather fight a whole Spitfire squadron in a Focke-D1 than have to watch this video again. Thanks for stopping by and see you on the next Magnets and Miracles.